Hello students, welcome to today's lecture. So in this lecture we are going to see about IoT and machine to machine communication systems, layers and design standardization. So this part will summarize the recent initiatives of international organization for design standardization of IoT and also machine to machine architectural layers and domains. So we are going to see one by one. So the IoT machine to machine systems. So in the previous lecture we have seen about what is IoT and what is the main difference between IoT and machine to machine communication. Here the machine to machine involves the communication between one device to another device without any human intervention. So the IoT, the major difference is we are processing the data in the cloud, and with the processed data we can use the application based on the user and application. So these systems standards device gives idea about designing a communication framework for connecting devices. So how the devices are connected and what protocols it follows, and also for their local area network working and provisions for data gathering. So what type of data which is gathered with what type of network protocol which is used for connection, these are all the parts which are going to deal with IoT standardization. So design standardization. So designing a data enrichment with a data consolidation and data transformation framework. So and designing a gateway components. So once the data is collected, the data will be transferred to the network through gateway, and also one device is also connected to the other device through the internet. So it acts as a mediator. Gateway acts as a mediator. So designing a gateway components which follows certain protocols and for connecting the device networks with the internet or web. So and then need of application and application supports. So after that the application comes into role. So APIs, and what are all the different APIs, application programming interface, and the transferring of data from the application layer with the user and application. So these framework which supports the services, applications and process. So this, here comes the design standardization. So IETF, that is an Internet Engineering Task Force. So it is an international body which initiates the actions for addressing and working on the recommendations for the engineering specifications. So mainly for Internet of Things. So this framework, this task force will initiate the addressing part and working on the what type of specifications. So what type of specification which is followed by the IoT. So it also suggests the specifications for the layers, which is different layers, link layer, transport layer, network layer and application layer. So in and also the engineering aspects for the IoT communications, networks and applications. So International Telecommunication Union, so ITU, so these are all the design standards. ITU, T, which is used for International Telecommunication Union for telecommunication purpose. And also ETSI, that is a European Telecommunication Standard Institute. So next one, Open Geospatial Consortium. So these three design standards are going to see in detail. So ITU, T, which suggests a reference model. So it is a reference model for IoT domain, network and transport capabilities for the IoT services and the applications at the application and application support layers. So this is one of the standard. So ETSI is the European Telecommunication Standard Institute, which initiates the development of set of standards for the networks. So here the network standards are discussed. So on the device and also the gateway domains. So because the gateway is the main part in order to communication between the machines, one device to another device with the help of network. So ETSI, which proposes the higher level architecture for application and service capabilities. So next thing is Open Geospatial Consortium. So it is also an international industry consortium which suggests the open standards for sensors. Okay, so open standards, what type of standards the sensor will follow, and also the different capabilities, discoveries, and quality, and also other aspects which supports to the geographical information. So here the sensors will collect the physical quantity, so it's a geographical data. So here there are certain standards which is followed by, which is proposed by this Open Geospatial Consortium. So following these, we are going to see about the different standardization efforts. In this first one, we are going to see about the modified OSI model for the IoT systems and machine-to-machine communication systems. So this is a gather enrich. We already seen that IoT application and services which consisting of gather, enrich, stream, manage, plus acquire, plus organize, plus analyze. So here the data which is gathered from the sensors and enriched with the help of microcontrollers, and also stream the data through network with the help of gateways, and also manage the data. So after collecting the data, managing, acquiring, organizing, and analyzing. So this is the major, managing, acquiring, organizing, and analyzing the data. So with the help of certain protocols and also the cloud, we are getting an output for the particular application. So this is the IoT application and service. So this is a OSI layer model. As we know that OSI, open systems interconnection model, so it supports the seven layer, basic layers. So starting from layer one, physical layer, next to that data link layer, then network layer, which is followed by transport layer, then session layer and presentation layer, and last the application layer. Here the gathering of data which is in the physical cum data link layer, and also enriching data adoption. So and then it is followed to the network layer and transport layer, the presentation and session layer, which is for application support. So here that data which is collected will be streamed to the network with the help of gateways. So and then application support, here the cloud computing takes place. So managing, acquiring, and organizing and analyzing the data. So after that, the application, user end application, which may be Android or which may be a web service. So on anything, it may be the software platform. So this is the OSI, modified OSI model. So it is a OSI protocols, which means a family of information exchange standards, which is developed by ISO and ITU-T. Okay, the seven layer OSI model is a standard model. So this seven layer model, which is a standard model for the communication purpose. So it gives the basic outline for designing a communication network. So various models for data interchanges, which consider the layers, which specified by the OSI model. So it modifies for simplicity according to the requirement. So we can modify it. So similarly, IETF, so suggests the modification in the OSI model. So this is the modified, model for IoT subsystems. So the data communication which takes place from one device end to the application end. So this is from the device end, and this is to the application end. So each layer which processes the received data and creates a new data stack. So data stacks is the storing of data in the layer, which transfers to the next layer, create a new data stacks. And also the data stacks can be transferred to the network layer through gateways. So it denotes, data stacks denotes the data which received after the actions at various in between layers. So that is here the layers are applications, presentation, session, transport, network, and data link and physical layer. So the data stacks, which is the data received at the various layers, so from physical to application layer. So this is the modified model. So here the equation which is find is gather, enrich, stream, and also managing, acquiring, organizing, and analyzing the data. So the process which takes place in between the layers, between the bottom functional layer to the top layer. So from the bottom layer, physical layer, to the top layer. So and also the device end which also receives the data from the application. So final device, user end device, which receives the data from the application or service after processing it in between layers. So here the input takes place, here the output, which is going to be application, okay, device end. So new applications and services which are present at the application layer. So whatever it may be, the application and services which is present in the application layer. So yeah, which is a modification to this is the application support, which uses the layer 5 and with the help of a protocols such as constraint application protocol. So IoT application and services which is commonly use these protocols for network communication. So the COAP protocol at the layer, which used for the request response interaction. So this type of model, so we have seen that client, between the client and the server, there is a request and response. Based on that request, the server will respond to the client. So similarly, the application support layer, which may include the process of data managing, acquiring, organizing, and analyzing, which are used for this application purpose and services. So the modifications, which is also at the data link layer, so that is a second layer, and the physical layer L1. Okay, so the new layers are data adaptation layer. So this is a new option which is in the layer in IoT. So the physical cum data link, which is in the layer 1. So this two layer, okay, so physical and data link layer are combined into a single layer in IoT systems and machine to machine communication. The new adoption layer, data adoption layer, is formed in the new systems, new IoT systems. So the gateway which enables the communication between the devices, network, and web application. So under physical IoT, machine to machine device hardware may integrate a wireless transceiver. Okay, so there is a connection of transceiver with the help of a communication protocol. The transfer bit may be wireless. So as well as the data link protocol for linking the data stacks of L1 and L2. So the first two layers, which links with the network layer, and also the data can be transported to the application support and cloud processing. So here the network layer, which acts as a intermediate between the communication purpose by using of protocols. So this is the six layers which are modified. So here the seven general layer, OSI layer, is modified into six layers. So the new layer is data adoption is included. The physical and data link layer are combined together. So this is the modified OSI model for IoT machine to machine systems. So next we are going to see about the ITU reference model. So ITU shows the correspondence of a model with the six layers modified OSI model. So from the six layer modified OSI layer OSI model, this ITU model is enriched. So it shows the correspondence of the model with the six layers modified OSI model. So here the RM, which is the reference model, which considers four layers, four main layers. That is a lowest layer, okay, so lowest layer, and then L1, this is L1, so this is L2, and this is L3, and this is L4. So L1 is a device layer, and as a device and gateway capabilities. Next to that, it is a transport layer, next to network layer, transport and network capabilities, and the next layer L3, okay, so this is a services and application support layer, and last layer is that application which are service, mainly for service and applications. So the L3 layer, which supports two types of capabilities, one is the generic and another one is specific support capabilities. So So the ITU reference model which recommends four layers each with different capabilities. So here the RM1. So RM1 device layer capabilities are similar to data adoption, which you have seen in the previous model, and also physical cum data network layers. So here the data adoption and physical cum data link layer are connected to a physical devices. So this is the RM1 layer. So next is the RM2, that level 2. So this is similar to RM functions at connectivity level. Reference model we have taken now. So this is similar to that one. So level 3, so here the which is similar to RM level 3, with RM level reference model 2 and third middle level functions of data abstraction, data accumulation, data element analysis and transformation. So this is also similar to that previous model. So and then the application layer, which is the processing of collaboration and process with the applications. So this is also which is compared with the reference model and also with the six layer OSI model. So next we are going to see about the, so we have seen the different types of ITU T model. So L1 device layer has device and gateway capabilities. Next to that L2, which has transport and network capabilities, and then next to that L3, service and application support layer. The support layer has two types of capabilities, which is generic and specific services or application support capabilities. So the last top layer is the application and services layer. So next going to see about the ETSI architecture. So these domain specifies the functional area. So here the high level architecture for functional and structured views are depicted. So each in this E2SI machine to machine domains and high level capabilities for each domain. So it also shows that architecture which corresponds with the six layer modified OSI model as well as the four layers of the ITUT reference model. So ETSI network domain which has six mainly six capabilities and functions. First one is that M2M application, and then second one is that M2M service capabilities, and third one is M2M management functions, fourth one is the network management functions, fifth one is the core network, for example 3G IP networks, network control functions, interconnections among networks. So sixth layer is that domain is that access network, which is for low power wide area network, and WLAN, why that is wide area network and also local area network, and then WiMAX networks. So these are all the device capabilities and functions. So ETSI device and gateway domain has the functional units. So these functional units are gateway between M2M devices and area networks, and the core and access network, and also possessing M2M services and capabilities applications. So M2M area network, for example Bluetooth, ZigBee, and then NFCs, PANs, personal area network, and local area network. So and then the last one is that machine to machine devices. So this model which shows the ETSI reference model. So here the data adaptation layer and the physical cum data link layer. So it is combined here the device and gateway domain which has M2M service capabilities, applications, and M2M area networks and M2M devices, and then application and network. So here the network, transport, application support and application, which is combined to that application and network domain, network domain, and applications which are data management, service capabilities, and core and access area networks. So these are all the different layer functions, and so these ETSI domain which is having high level capabilities. So far we have seen the international organizations IETF, IETUT and ETSI which taken the initiative and recommendations for the layers, capabilities, domains and architecture standardization for IoT M2M systems. So these three international standards which propose the conceptual framework, and then IoT architecture and reference models for having a different similarities with a different similarities. So that ITSI 6-layer model, which is proposes an application support layer in place of a session and presentation layer in the OSI model. So COAP is an application support layer protocol. So next is that ITUT reference model, which is having a layer of application service and three more layers for three other capabilities.